Today we're going to talk about the final two tests that we're going to use in Calculus 2 to analyze whether series converge or diverge. And to do this, I want to begin by recalling the geometric series, which was really how we began our introduction into series. And for the geometric series, what we had was a series with a fixed ratio r. It was the sum of a times that ratio r to the power of n minus 1. And whether the geometric series converged or diverged depended on that value of r. When the absolute value of r was less than 1, it not only converged, but we knew what it converged to. And when the absolute value of r was greater than or equal to 1, it diverged. Now, I'm going to call the terms in the sequence a sub n, as I normally do, but just to distinguish it, the blue a is a constant that multiplies out, and the a sub n is the entire thing. And what I want to do is I want to investigate the ratio of successive terms in a geometric series. Indeed, I want to consider an plus 1 divided by an. Now, the whole point of a geometric series is that this is just going to be that ratio r. Indeed, in the numerator here, if I plug in n plus 1 into our formula, I just get ar to the n. And then in the denominator, don't change it at all, ar to the n minus 1. Then the a's cancel and most of the r's cancel and I'm just left with r. So the point I'm trying to hammer home here is that for a geometric series, it's really defined by this fixed ratio r, that the ratio of an plus 1 to an is just r. Now, we're going to use this as a model for our ratio test and for our root test. We're going to say, what if a series is not a geometric series, but in the limit, as your n gets really large, it starts to look a lot like a geometric series, then maybe it behaves in a similar way. So indeed, what we're going to have is this. The ratio test considers the same ratio of the an plus 1s to the an's that I did before. And if that ratio is less than 1, so in the limit as n goes to infinity, it becomes a number l which is less than 1, then it converges just like it did in the geometric series. Likewise, if I consider the limit of the ratios and its number which is greater than 1 or diverges, then we're going to say that the series is going to diverge. And then in the final case, this is where it differs a little bit from the geometric series. In the final case is what happens if this is equal to 1, in which case the test is useless. It's inconclusive. It doesn't tell you one way or the other. Now, the way I think about the ratio test is that in the limit as n goes to infinity, it starts approaching a geometric series. So if that ratio is firmly less than 1, then much like for a geometric series, it converges. If that ratio is firmly bigger than 1, then like the geometric series, it diverges. But if it's exactly equal to 1, that inconclusive case, then the fact that this is only true in the limit means I don't know whether it's accumulating a little bit bigger than a geometric series, a little bit smaller than a geometric series. I don't know what it's going to do when it goes to exactly 1. So let's see how this works in an example. I've got the sum of 2 to the n over n factorial. So to apply the ratio test, let me consider the ratio of the an plus 1s over the an's. And what I do for the an plus 1 is I take that 2 to the n over n factorial and I just plug it in. So it's 2 to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial. And then in the denominator, it's 2 to the n over n factorial. I don't change that one. Well, I'm going to go and collect things a little bit. So I can rewrite this as put all the 2's in one spot and all the factorials in the other. So it's a 2 to the n plus 1 over a 2 to the n. And then an n factorial over an n plus 1 factorial. I've done the business where when you have a quotient of quotients, you can bring it up like this. Now, how do I figure out what this is going to do? The 2's are not so bad. 2 to the n plus 1 over 2 to the n, it cancels and you're just left with a single copy of 2. But what about the factorial terms? Recall that, say, 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. It's multiplying all the integers down to 1. So if I have n factorial, it's like n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 times n minus 3 dot dot dot, always subtracting 1. That is, I can replace this with the yellow part, the 2 doesn't change, but the factorials are expanded as this n minus 1, n minus 2, all the way down 3, 2, 1. N plus 1 factorial expands as n plus 1 times n minus 1, n minus 2, dot, 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 3, 2, 1. And most of those are going to cancel. In fact, the only thing in the blue that doesn't cancel is that 1 n plus 1 in the denominator. So what do we get? 2 over 1, that's the yellows, that happens pretty simply. And then 1 over n plus 1 from the factorial portion. And indeed, now we have an n in the denominator. We're taking the limit as n goes to infinity. This is equal to 0. 0 is a number less than 1. And so by the ratio test, we're going to say that this thing converges. So the way I think about this is that in the limit as n goes to infinity, the ratios between the terms get closer and closer just to multiplying by zero. And that's something that if it was a geometric series and it was zero to the n, you'd certainly say it was going to converge. So too does it here. Now let's go and see two examples where it's the inconclusive case. The sum of 1 over n and 1 over n squared. These are both p-series, so we can apply the p-test to it. The top one is p equal to 1, so that diverges, and the bottom one is p equal to 2, which converges. But if I consider the ratio, okay, for the top one, the ratio of the an plus 1s over the an's, I plug it in, so 1 over n plus 1 over 1 over n, do a little bit of algebra to bring it up, and I get n over n plus 1, and this is a limit I can do. Highest power on the top, highest power on the bottom, n over n, so it just becomes 1. Likewise, for the bottom one, if I consider this quotient of an plus 1s over an, well, 1 over n plus 1 squared divided by 1 over n squared, again, we'll bring it up, and what do we get? N squared over n plus 1 squared. Now I want to do a little bit of work in the denominator here. I've got this thing, I should probably expand it out, so I will do that. That gives me n squared plus 2n plus 1. And then highest power on the top is n squared. Highest power in the bottom is n squared, so again, its limit is just 1. So in this case, the ratio test is useless. It doesn't tell me either of these things. Both of the limits just appear to be 1. But in the first case, it diverges, in the second, it converges. So indeed, this ratio test is inconclusive when the ratio in the limit is only 1. All right, next thing we're going to do is very similar to the ratio test, but it is called the root test. Notice that it looks very similar. Except I am no longer considering the ratio of successive terms, the an plus 1 divided by the an. But the rest of it's the same. You look at instead at the nth root of an, and it's either a number less than 1, in which case it converges, it's a number greater than 1, in which case it diverges, or it's a number equal to 1, in which case the test fails and it's inconclusive. Now, why are we looking at the nth root of an, and how do we get this back to the geometric series? Well, let's see an example like this one. So in this series, I have blah to the power of n. It sort of looks like a geometric series, right? Like a geometric series was an r to the power of n, except instead of a fixed number r, I have this weird quotient thing. So if this weird quotient thing in the limit becomes a value, then I can think of that as being analogous to the geometric series. If the quotient is going to become a value of L, which is either less than 1, bigger than 1, or equal to 1, I can apply these conditions from my root test. So really what I'm interested in is considering the limit of the inside of my brackets, the inside of this thing to the power of n. If that thing goes to a fixed ratio r, then I can do the sort of analogy by geometric series and claim this root test. So how do I actually do that? Well, I am going to take the nth root of all of this stuff to the power of n. Nth root is like to the power of 1 over n, so I can rewrite this as the stuff in brackets to n over n, which is just the same thing as just stuff just in brackets itself, and that's really what I want to get my hands on. That's what I want to consider the limit of. And if I take this limit, indeed it goes to this ratio of 1 half, which is less than 1, so it converges via the root test. So the big idea for both the ratio and the root test is that the thing we understand well is the geometric series when there is a fixed ratio r on the terms, but depending on how it presents, I can get things that approximate a fixed r. At least in the limit as n goes to infinity, it becomes this fixed r. And sometimes we're going to use a ratio of the two terms explicitly to get our hands at that thing we want to be a fixed ratio. And sometimes we take the nth root of things. But either way, we're looking to get something that has a common ratio in the limit as n goes to infinity.